You're now watching The Wash Daily. Today in news, there's a hemp publication. Hemp Today is out of China, it looks like. And they were talking about the role of hemp in the future for China's development. Cannabis has been significant in China since thousands of years ago, and it's not a new thing at all. Although China is very much against people using cannabis for THC purposes, they've been using hemp to create textiles, and they still do. They're looking to increase their presence in the hemp market globally and to transition to a cottonized form of hemp and from cotton into hemp farming. A big part of what's happening is people realize how horrible cotton is for the planet and that cotton really isn't a good material to make clothes from. Hemp is a much better material. The Chinese know this and they're putting a lot of money into their infrastructure so they can start putting out hemp-based materials, not just for their own country, but for the whole world. And they're also looking to increase hempcrete production in their country as well. Also in news, a very interesting guy, a Latvian hemp farmer and inventor, Kristaps Eglītis, has now put together what's called the Herdmaster 1000. It works with hemp. It's a mini decorticator. A decorticator can cost millions of dollars. This one doesn't. It's designed for small farming. It's about $10,000 retail price, according to the website. And it looks like it's available right away. What the decorticator does, it allows the farmers to turn their hemp plants into usable material for construction purposes. Hempcrete is going to be a big deal, a lot of people are thinking, because of the amount of benefits that come out of using hempcrete. It's a very easy material to make, and insulating, and it ends up being a much better choice for buildings and concrete. Currently in the construction industry, there's a shortage on sand, and concrete's becoming more difficult to get. There's a ton of benefits that come with transitioning into hemp materials. If we can grow hemp, it also offsets CO2. Also in news, in Israel, there's a startup company, CannBreed, manipulating cannabis on a genetic level using CRISPR technology. What they're looking to do is make a cannabis plant that's resistant to mold. Green powdery mildew is a big problem, especially for new growers, but for all growers. They're looking to genetically enhance the plants that they would be resistant to green powdery mildew. The question, what will happen as a result of the genetic modification? Lots of old school cannabis users don't want anything to do with any genetic modification happening to their cannabis. They want their cannabis the way it's always been, and they don't want it manipulated in any way. Now, scientists across the globe got access to cannabis to study it. It's interesting to see the studies they're doing and the findings they're documenting. Thanks for watching The Wash Daily.